It's the eve of the Super Bowl, and we have a great show for you tonight. We'll be covering Broncos, Bears, and beatdowns. I'm your host, Adam Skirko. First, we'll begin with the weather. I'm Adam, your meteorologist, and this is the climate report. El Nino this year is the strongest it has ever been on record. That's bad news if you're a penguin, but great news if you're a chaos-loving anarchist who just wants to watch the world burn. Or drown! Polar ice flows are melting and receding at an alarming rate. The surface area of ice on the Great Lakes has decreased from last year more than 900%, and current weather trends suggest that California will be completely submerged within 2 weeks. Data also indicates that the East Coast will be completely snowbound for the next 20,000 years, while the breadbasket of the United States will face Gulf storms coupled with mass shark migrations, resulting in the fabled Sharknado. The mountain states may or may not face complete obliteration from a supervolcano, but there is a silver lining. Here in sunny Washington State, spring has come along with a balmy 70-degree weather. There appears to still be snow on the ground, Adam. Oh yes, completely natural for 70 degree Kelvin weather. Watch out for those migrating packs of wampas, though. They can be a minor inconvenience for anyone wanting to keep their insides inside. I'm not a good weatherman. Right, now let's go to the road conditions. Over to you, Amber.
It's rough.
Thanks, Adam. I'm Adam Skirko, your senior sports reporter, and this is the Sports Report. The Pro Bowl was a blowout this year. Michael Irvin put together a stacked team of Russell Wilson, Julio Jones, and A.J. Green, and crushed Jerry Rice's team by a final score of 49-27. In other news, former WWE wrestler CM Punk has signed with the UFC for an 8-fight contract and is set to debut at UFC 199 in June. The Super Bowl should be one of the best we've seen in a while because we have the number one offense, Carolina Panthers, going up against the number one defense, Denver Broncos. And this is all happening in sunny Santa Clara, California. That's all for me. Back to you, Adam. Thanks, Adam. I'm a 2016 GOP presidential candidate, Donald Trump, who's joining us via phone call to talk about his campaign strategy for winning the GOP nomination. Mr. Trump, it seems like you're losing your footing in the presidential race.
You know, one who wins without problem, it's just victory. But one who wins with many problems, that's history. And you know what? We're gonna keep winning and keep winning until you're sick and tired of winning. But you know what? We're gonna keep winning anyway.
What is your strategy to garner the nomination?
I use emotion for the many and reserve reason for the few. The doom of a nation can only be averted by a storm of flowing passion. But only, and only, those who are passionate themselves can rouse passion in others. And I have to say that my constituents, my followers, are very, very passionate.
What do you think the secret to your success is?
Who says I'm not under the protection of God?
Evidenced by your absence at the Republican debate, would you shed light on your disregard for our current political process?
Now, success is the sole earthly judge of right and wrong. And what luck for rulers that men do not think. Am I right? Am I right? Of course I'm right. And you know, I am really, really successful.
And finally, why are you running for president?
Why am I running for president? To make America great again.
I'm Adam Skirko, the nightly show's resident movie critic. Tonight, we take a cold, hard look into the wilderness with The Revenant. Perennial Oscar nominee Leonardo DiCaprio stars as Hugh Glass, the famed frontiersman. We follow Glass and his trapping company as they brave the many perils of the stark environment of Montana and South Dakota in the 1820s. Following an Indian attack, Glass is mauled by a bear and left for dead. Of his survival and revenge. We are thrust right into the blistering endurance of the character. The film is gorgeously shot, brilliantly scored, and intensely acted. This is a harsh and beautiful film, recently nominated for 12 Academy Awards, and it's easy to see why it's one of the year's best.